What is wireframing, and how can you go from a quick pen and paper sketch to a great digital wireframe in under 5 minutes? In this video, we'll give you an overview of the concept, show you how they work, and help you get started creating your own wireframes. Before we get started, if you're interested in learning more about wireframing and UX design, CareerFoundry has a great free short course. The link is in the description below. Please share any questions you have about wireframing in the comments below. Let's dive in and get started. What actually is a wireframe? Essentially, it's a low-fidelity sketch of a digital interface, the outline or bare bones of the key elements of a design. The purpose of a wireframe is to help the designer plan how everything is laid out on the screen before they get bogged down in the nitty-gritty details of the design. It also provides a basic artifact that can be tested with users to confirm or deny different design choices. Imagine you're designing a mobile app. Before you decide on the perfect colors and design aesthetic, you will create wireframes for each basic screen. This will help you plan out exactly how the user will undertake tasks, engage with key elements, and navigate through your product or app. Traditionally, there are two types of wireframes: the physical hand-drawn sketch and digital wireframes. A hand-drawn sketch is made simply using paper and pens and markers, and a digital wireframe can be made using a variety of different tools. You can find a great list of both free and paid tools in the description of this video. Whether a hand-drawn sketch wireframe or a digital wireframe, they're both made up of the same things: basic fundamental shapes to represent the key elements that you would see on a screen in their simplest form, and they're usually in black, white, and sometimes some gray. The important thing about wireframes is to keep it simple. More detail can be distracting, and it's important to keep things to their most basic fundamental forms. Once you've got some initial ideas down on paper, you might notice that not everything fits quite as you envisaged. Take the time to do a quick second sketch and refine key elements if they don't fit quite right. Digital wireframes are a great step after hand-drawn sketches because they're easy to share with colleagues and the rest of the design team, who can continue to add layers of complexity and polish. So hopefully this gives you a better idea of what a wireframe actually is and what it might look like in the real world. Before we get started creating your very first wireframe, if you have any questions about what we've covered so far, let me know in the comments below and we'll get back to you as soon as we can. Let's get started creating your first wireframe. We'll start with a hand-drawn sketch and then digitize it in a free online wireframing tool. So let's get started making a really quick sketch wireframe of a login screen. I'll start with sketching a basic rectangle to represent the shape of the phone screen and our boundaries that we're working inside. Then I think about what the main elements that I definitely need on that screen. The first thing I can think of is that the user will need to type in a username or an email address. So we'll have a text field, which we can represent with a rectangle there and maybe an at symbol to show that it's an email field. The next thing I can think of is that the user will need to click a button to actually log in after they've typed their email. So I'm going to put another rectangle here underneath that will be a button, and putting the word on there, for example, login, to illustrate that it's the login button. Now I think about what other things might I want to put here. And while I'm doing this wireframe, I'm really thinking through the process. So this won't be the first wireframe that I do. I'll come up with some ideas as I go and then realize I want to change my sketch and start again. But it's only taken me 2 minutes to sketch it out. So this is one of the main points of wireframing, is to try planning and mapping out different things on the screen, see where they might fit, and then revising the sketches very quickly. So what else needs to go on this screen? I probably need to have the logo of the company somewhere. I can illustrate that with a really simple circle or rectangle somewhere at the top. That shows it's the logo. Some other things that I might need to put here are forgot login or need help logging in. So I put some text here. Help logging in. And some other things that we see really commonly in login screens is the ability to log in through a different account, like a Google account or a Facebook account. So perhaps underneath the main login, I decide to put Facebook login and Google login and show where those logos go. Underneath Facebook login, Google login, And the final element that I might add is a nice image to make the login screen feel warm and welcoming. So now that I've thought that through quickly with some quick sketching, I want to do a quick revision to just make sure that everything feels like it's in the right place. So I'm going to re-sketch my rectangle, put the image at the top here. The logo will also go here. And then some nice space this time in between the email field and the image and the button. And underneath, Facebook and Google. Okay, so that's my quick example of my first sketch where I quickly tested out some positioning and ideas and a quick resketch in one more minute to really show how I want everything laid out on the screen in a very simple way. So you can see that's taken me a maximum of a couple of minutes for two sketches and a clearly laid out final version that we're now going to digitize in a free online wireframing tool. So let's dive into this free online tool called Wireframe.cc. In this tool, I have a really basic functionality, which is really great and easy to get started, and you won't find yourself spending hours and hours trying to create perfect little details, which is exactly what we want with a wireframe. There are a few different settings you can set up beforehand. This one is set up for a desktop app, so if we were creating a full page website, but I prefer to go over here to the top left and change to a blank canvas setting. So we just have an empty board to work with. And then we can really simply recreate what we've done in the hand sketch in digital format. So I'm going to drag a nice long rectangle to represent the area of the phone screen. And when I release the mouse button there, it shows that I can choose exactly what shape I wanted, and I just want the rectangle. So now I really quickly go back and look at my sketch and recreate each thing. I'll start with the image at the top of the screen, and I've got a rectangle there, and now I'm going to choose the image option, and it automatically puts that crossed line through it to indicate that it's an image in the wireframe. Now I want to put my logo in the top left corner, and I'll choose the circle option to do that, to represent that. And I'll keep going down the page now, putting in the elements as I did them in my hand-drawn sketch. A rectangle for the email login field, a rectangle for the button. And when I click now on that rectangle that I just made and double click, I can choose a color for it. So this is how I'm going to choose to represent what the button looks like, the difference between a button and a text input field. So now when we look at that, it's a bit clearer that that's the input field for the email and that's the button. And on here as well, I can create some text. So another rectangle, call that text, and I'm going to call this forgot my password. I'm going to make it underlined. And I'm going to make this a little bit smaller so that it's not really drawing my eye, because this is something that we want to position on the screen in a way that's accessible and it's there if you need it, but it doesn't draw the user's attention because not everyone will actually need to use this. So I'm going to make that text a bit smaller so that it's not so prominent. And now I'm going to do another piece of text for the word login on the login button. And I'm going to make that a lot bigger and more obvious, because that's the main function that the user wants to do on this screen, is to type in their email or user ID and then click the login button. So that I'm actually going to make bigger so that really stands out in a much more prominent way. So I'm going to put the last two elements on the screen, which were the two alternative login options. So a Facebook login button and a Google login button. So I do that again with the same drag and release, and then choose the rectangle, and I'll make a second one right away here. So I'm going to copy and paste the text from above just to make it slightly quicker instead of redrawing an entirely new element. And I'm going to call this button Login with Facebook. And I'm going to make the text just slightly smaller and less prominent. I'll remove the bold there and make it a little bit smaller, just so that there is one clear action on this screen, which is to put in your email address and log in. And these are now secondary options that are there as well. So you can already see that on this screen, there is a hierarchy or a priority order of the information. There's the main function of the login email address and the login button. There's the secondary functions of alternative login options. You can also log in with Facebook or Google. And then in much smaller text, there's the forgot my password, which is something's going wrong. Not every user will need this, but if they look for it, it will be there. But it's that third priority option, so that it's very easy for the user to quickly scan and see which things are the most important, or what's the main action on that screen. So this is what wireframing really helps us with: quickly sketching out and planning what information needs to be on the screen, where it could go, and seeing what it looks like when we lay it out like that, adjusting the options so that the primary action is the most obvious for the user, and adjusting the basic fundamental properties of the core elements on the screen without worrying too much yet about exact styles and colors and fonts, but just really thinking about the information and is it in the right place and is it easy to see and use. Hopefully now, after watching this video, you have a better understanding of what a wireframe actually is and how it looks in the real world. Now you should be able to create your own wireframes using pen and paper sketching and digital wireframing tools like wireframe.cc. If you've done wireframing before, we're keen to know what your favorite methods and tools are. Please let us know in the comments below. If you're interested in learning more about wireframing, CareerFoundry has a great in-depth article that will walk you through the process of creating your very first wireframe. You can find out more in the description below. I really hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please give it a like and subscribe to this channel for more weekly content just like this from CareerFoundry. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you again soon. Quick paper digital paper. a digital paper. I'm laughing, it's fun. So hopefully now you'll be able to create, easy to share with the duress of the design team. Yeah, that was it, okay. Yay, look at this. Okay.